Hey guys, sorry for the delay. I know it's been a while, but we are finally continuing with part four. This one will get a little interesting. We'll have some issues with Illustrator finally, which will cause us to eventually move into Photoshop. But yeah, the process that we use to get there will still be important. So here we have my 3D sphere from last time, and I'm just going to make a whole bunch of duplications of this, and each one I'm just going to move that spotlight, so that way I can get sort of this spotlight moving across the surface of it as if there is a star revolving around this planet and not just a static stationary light. So I'm just duplicating it a whole bunch, just moving it a little bit, pressing OK, and I'm moving it through the appearance window with the 3D revolve tool or 3D revolve filter. And so I'm going to create quite a few of these. It's going to take a moment, and it'll take you even longer because I'm doing this on fast forward. But that's okay. It's all right. You can start to see that moving across, and hopefully as you're doing this, you get sort of the idea of what it's going to look like. Now right now, we're just moving this across the front of the sphere, but what if we want to move it behind the sphere? And so we're going to have to do that as well. So I'm at the very edge, but if you noticed, I clicked down at the bottom. So right here, I need it to move behind, right? I don't want it to be in front. If I click this button, it moves the light source behind the 3D object. And so hopefully, you can sort of see here that that light source is behind. And as we keep moving it, you can see there's just a little bit of light on the edges as we're moving it behind. I'm not going to have as many behind. Realistically, I should, so that the duration of the light moving behind the sphere is equivalent to the front, but I'm not too worried about that. I just want to give the idea of the light source actually revolving around the whole planet. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this layer that I made earlier in the previous video where I use the Pathfinder window with the union tool to combine all of my pixels into like one shape. Because right now my sphere is too big, which I already mentioned. So I'm going through and I'm locking all of the other spheres. So I have just one sphere that's unlocked. And I'm going to grab both my shape and my sphere, and I'm going to do clipping mask make. It's important that I locked everything else, because if I didn't, it might have clipped more than I wanted to. Now I'm going to go ahead and duplicate that again, and I'm going to lock up what I don't want, and I'm going to go ahead and click on that next sphere. Let's go ahead and move that out of the way. So we're going to grab the pixelated circle along with my sphere, and we're going to clipping mask make, and oops, I didn't select my other sphere. So if I click over here on the right side, I can actually select it that way instead of using the sort of the holding shift technique to click on multiple ones or the drag. Let's make sure that it's visible so we can actually select it. Now I have both selected. You can see the little yellow dot, the little blue dot, and I can do clipping mask make. And that one's done. And so now I need the next sphere. Go ahead and lock that up since I don't want to modify that one. Go ahead and unlock this one. Make sure it's visible. Duplicate this top layer again. Go ahead and hide those so they're not in the way. Grab both of those. And clipping mask make once again. And so we're just going to keep doing that over and over again for each and every 3D sphere that I've created. Now, I can go all the way up into the menus for clipping mask make for each and every one. However, if I want to save a little bit of time, I could instead use the keyboard shortcut, which is Command 7, which I'll do in a few minutes. It's going to take a few minutes to do each one of these, but that's all right. And it's going to take you long because, once again, I'm fast-forwarding this. And as you can see now, I am using my keyboard shortcut, and I'm able to save a bit of time by not having to go through the menu each and every time. And we're just about done. There we go. I think I've got all of them done. Go ahead and unlock all of these. And if I make them all visible, which will probably take a moment to load. Yeah, you can see it's sort of clicking in slowly, eating up a fair amount of RAM. How much RAM it consumes is going to depend on the size of your objects and the number of pixels you have and how big you've made those pixels, that background. Well, pixels, they're not real pixels, you know, the air quotes pixels. Is it done? I think it's done. So, because of all those overlays, all you see is a big dark sphere. Let's go ahead and actually try to export this and see what happens. So we'll take this into a Flash file. Notice I have my background layers locked, my pixels, my pixeled spheres, and I only have the 3D spheres that I've revolved unlocked. So what I'm going to do is you can see all of my layers here in this little menu. And I've also told to export static layers, and hopefully what that will do is keep my backgrounds, layer 2 and layer 3 are the backgrounds that I don't want to be individual frames. Or we're just going to see what's going to happen. So frame rate, we'll make this a little bit faster, maybe 5. A little bit higher. We'll go 10. 10 should be decent. And let's see what happens. Done. That was pretty quick. I don't think it's done yet. I think it's still processing. All right, now is it done? So let's go ahead and try opening this. We'll try opening it with just any web browser, really, should be able to do it. And let's see if this worked out. We'll just go to File, Open, find the globe, and whenever you're ready, computer, here we go. The 3D light is working fairly decently. It's got some weird little indentions where the seams meet, I guess, but where is my planet? So apparently the layer 2 and 3 locked up the way they were didn't quite do what I wanted to, so we're going to have to try exporting again. It's a little laggy too. So let's try something else. I think what we're going to do is copy and paste my sphere into the back of each individual layer. So that way it is behind the 3D sphere, and I just won't use my background layers. I was hoping that locking them would keep those sort of in the background the whole time and change the frames on top, but I guess not. So now I need to paste in my sphere behind each one of those 3D spheres on that specific layer, so each layer is its own individual frame. So I'm just going in. I've already copied my 3D, well, not 3D, I've already copied my pixel globe, my flat globe that you see here, and I'm just doing paste and back for each and individual layer. And the hotkey for that in Illustrator is Command B. So instead of having to go into the menu each and every time, I'm able to do this a little bit faster by hitting Command B once I click on each layer. You can start to see that it's struggling a little bit as I jump from layer to layer as it's loading in all of those 3D overlaid spheres. But it's handling it not too bad for the small amount of RAM that I have on this machine. This one's a little bit of an older machine. And I think we've got it on pretty much all of them now. Once again, might take you a little bit longer than it did for me. But that's okay. You'll get through it. Just do a Command S real fast, just to make sure I don't crash anything as I'm trying to export it, as I've just loaded in quite a bit of extra information. I've just loaded my pixelated globe onto every single one of those files, so I just added quite a bit more information to this file. We'll try doing a flash file again. And let's go ahead and forget the static layers parts. Everything should be fine here. Keep in mind that we're exporting this as SWF frames, not SWF files. So you need to make sure you have changed that on basic if you haven't. Ours is set up that way from the previous video that we made a flash file with. So once this is done, we'll try it out. Give it just a moment just to make sure that everything finishes exporting without any problems. All right, we'll see if it's done yet. So open file, reopen my globe, and have my window a little bit smaller, so hopefully it'll load a little bit smoother. There it goes. And that doesn't quite look right still. That looks the same. Oh, that's not, ooh, that's, yeah, that's exactly what we wanted, isn't it? That's beautiful. All right, well, that clearly didn't work quite the way that I was expecting. And that's okay, because we will figure out how to make this work, because we're not going to spend all that time that we just did without having some sort of decent product to show for it. Yeah, that's great. Great. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep, great. Just great. Alright, let's go ahead and close that. Command W to close it. Well, that wasn't ideal. Let's go back into Illustrator and let's just try exporting one more time. Maybe that was a bug. Maybe that just didn't export right. We're gonna try this again. We're just gonna re-export. Maybe try lossless. SWF frames is marked, so that's good. And we'll just give it a shot. We'll just see what happens. Maybe that was a bug. Like a one-time bug, not like a permanent bug. Maybe it was a permanent bug. I don't know. We'll see. So the export should be about done. Right? I think so. Let's go ahead and minimize this, and let's try opening our export again. Once again, I have my browser window a little bit smaller, so hopefully it will load faster, smoother. Just do file open. And there's our globe, and does it work? Is it good? Come on. Oh, it's not good. It's not good. Right? Same thing? It's gonna be the same thing? It's the same thing. Alright, that's okay. That's alright. We're gonna go ahead and call this it for video 4. In the next video, we'll go ahead and load up Photoshop, and we're going to find a way to make this work. We will make this work. Let's go ahead and just close this for now. Thanks for watching. Even though things didn't turn out quite the way we wanted, hopefully you feel like you learned a thing or two, or at least a thing or two not to do. Next time we'll continue with Photoshop and we will make this work. Thanks, guys. Bye.